Hello, welcome to this video about managing the internal domain, users and groups with command line for Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. In this video, we will describe the use of a command line tool to manage local users and groups for the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager system. We will describe the need to use a command line tool to add users and groups to the system before importing them and managing them through the administration portal. Using the tool, we will show how to add and remove the internal domain, users and groups to the system. We will see how to set user-related account settings and user passwords. Then we will see how to query user and group information from the command line. Before local users can use their login credentials to access the administration and VM portal sites, new users and groups are added to the system using the overt-aaa-jdbc-tool command utility. This utility is used to manage user and group accounts on the internal domain, which is also called the local domain. As mentioned earlier, the command line tool is used to add and remove users and groups, reset users' passwords, and change default account settings. To run the command line tool, root-level privileges are required. Permission settings and functional roles carried out by the user can be assigned through the administration portal after the new user or group is created and imported into the system. New users must be created before they can be added and assigned roles and permissions through the administration portal. The roles and permissions assigned give the user the ability to manage elements of the cloud environment, for example, using the VM portal to start creating virtual machines. The permissions can also be associated to users through group accounts. The overt-aaa-jdbc-tool command manages user accounts on the internal domain. Changes made with the tool take effect immediately and do not require you to restart the overt engine service. Passwords for users are set and reset using the command line tool. By default, the following password policy applies to user accounts on the internal domain. Passwords must be a minimum of 6 characters. 3 previous passwords used cannot be used again when changing the password. Using the command overt-aaa-jdbc-tool settings show will inform about the various password policy settings and default settings.
Internal domain, also called local users and created through command line, are local to the overt database for the system. External directory servers such as LDAP or Active Directory can be attached and offer users to the system from external domains. All user types are easily added to the system in the same way through an administration portal dialog. After adding both user types to the overt database, they are treated similarly in the administration portal when granting permissions. Passwords for the users are managed by the respective tool or system that was used to initially create them.
Groups are first created with the command line tool and then imported into the administration portal. In the portal, roles with associated permissions can be assigned to groups, which are then inherited by the users. So let's have a look at the use of the tool to create and manage users and groups. I have already established an SSH connection to the host running the overt engine, and we're looking at the command line. I earlier changed to have root-level privileges to run these commands. First, I will look at the overt-aaa-jdbc-tool command help information. To get this, I run the command with the --help option. We see in the output the command options that can be applied to the command and the modules that can be implemented. For example, the user, group, or query module. Running the command again, but this time looking for help for the user module, we run the command specifying the module user, followed by the --help option. This time we can see modules such as add, edit, delete, password reset are available to use. And if you query help for the user add modules, it shows many options that can be associated with a new user, but it also shows that there are no more command modules that can be run with the add module. So to show the command working, let's add a new user with the command. First, let's clear the screen with the clear command. To add a new user, we run the command overt-aaa-jdbc-tool user add, followed by the name of the new user, in this case, TRN user 1. The output shows the user was added successfully. To set a password for the new user or to reset a password for an existing user, we use the command overt-aaa-jdbc-tool user password-reset and identify the user. You must also set a value for the --password-valid-2 option, otherwise the password expiry time defaults to the time of the last login. Passwords must be at least 6 characters long, and when resetting a password, the new password cannot be the same as the last 3 ones used. Here we set the password expiry date with the dash dash password dash valid dash 2 option to be 1st of August 2025 and a time of 12 noon at GMT minus 8 hours. We enter the password twice and it's set. We can verify the added user with the user show modules followed by the username. It shows us any modified settings we have applied, in this case the password valid setting. Just like setting the password, we can use the password-reset option to modify it. And we must give the --password-valid-2 option also. Here we set it for the year, month, day and time with the 0800 identifying GMT minus 8 hours. Now let's look at adding another user called trnuser2, this time setting the first and last name attributes. With the attribute first name, we give a first name of Bill, and the attribute last name, we give a last name of Smith. Again, for every new user, we must set a password. Here we simply use the same password valid2 setting as the previous user. We can also use the tool to disable a user account, using the command module user edit, identifying the username, and setting the flag to plus disabled. To remove a user, we use the command with the user delete module and identify the username. Here we delete the recently added user trnuser2. Just like users, groups must be created first with the tool before they can be imported and managed through the administration portal. Using the command with the module group add, we add a group called trngroup10. If we want to add additional users to a group, we use the group-manage user add module and identify the users to add with the string --user equal followed by the username. We can add multiple users to a group by repeatedly adding the same option string to the command identifying all the users to add. Here we are adding users trnuser11 and trnuser12 to the same group, trngroup10. We can see details of the group using the command with the group show module and the name of the group. Deleting a group means using the group delete module and identifying the name of the group. Here we are deleting the group trngroup10. To see the default account settings applied with the commands, we can use the command with the settings show module. These default settings can also be changed using the command. In this video, we looked at the use of a command line tool to manage users and groups for the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager system. We described the need to use command line to add users and groups to the system before managing them through the administration portal. Using the command line tool, we saw how to add and remove users and groups to the system. We saw how to view account settings and set user passwords. Then we saw how to query user and group information using the command line tool. Oracle provides an extensive number of resources which you can use to find out more about this subject and others. You can find documentation on Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager at the link shown. There is a comprehensive Oracle Linux curriculum available to support a full range of Linux administration skills for cloud, on-premise, and hybrid users. For more information, or to get started on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to cloud.oracle.com. And for more training on Linux on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, go to the link shown here. That's the end of the video. Thanks for watching.